Yeah, I've had the canvas sitting on it for a couple of days and I've got this unhooked, but it's really starting to fit nice up top. The heat helps the fabric kind of settle. You know, when you sew something and you've wallered it around for a couple weeks, it just kind of doesn't fit like it's supposed to. So I let it sit on here for, it's been in the heat now for about 3 days. And I'm gonna pull it off and get ready to finish polishing on the trailer. And I made the awning for it. So that clips up under here. And I just need to trim that. Just used little mini snap rings or carabiners to clip it on. So those will just stay on the awning when you take the awning off. And then I made a flap. So I sewed a flap that will hang down so you can hang your lights or whatever off of it. I eventually want to put fringe on it. These originally had like a white fringe on them, but I just made the little flap for so you can take a clothespin or a clip or something and clip it on. And then I also did this says Higgins in the font that's on the trailer cut out, and then when the sun shines through that, it projects Higgins down on the ground. It's so dark with the green that I put the skyline in. We may regret that. I may decide to take that out and put fabric in, but for right now, I'm gonna leave it in there. We'll camp with it this camping trip and kind of see how it goes. But I gotta put a grommet there. I'm missing a grommet, and then a grommet on each corner for our tent poles to hold that up. But I think it's gonna work out okay. It's about 7 feet that comes out off of the tent. So it should be enough. And I just used a spray upholstery or headliner adhesive, that 3M spray stuff. This stuff here. Show you what I used. This. That's what I used for the lettering. I just cut it out with a hot knife. So I think we're going to call the canvas portion of this project complete. And we're gonna pull that off. It's fitting really nice now that it's been on here for a day or two. Everything's starting to tighten up, you know, which looks good. It's really starting to fit like it's supposed to. So pull that off and we're gonna get started with the first thing, which is banging out this dent that's down here. Right here in this corner. And then it's gonna require me to put a jack inside, because inside the little cubby it's all punky and pooched up back in there, so we're gonna have to straighten that out before we can kind of work out here, because the metal is pulling it that way, the little dent that's inside there. So we'll try to work on that. I don't know that I'll be able to get it all out, but we'll work on it. So we'll work on that polish, and then I'll probably jump on to taillights. I've been fabbing up the Land Rover portion too, so we'll get to share some of that. So let's get this off of here and get going on some polish. And then I'm going to sandblast the rims and paint those up. Alright, let's get this off of here. I've got that all off of there, and I'm ready to kind of start working on getting that caved in section of this side kind of worked out. Kind of hard to see, but this whole side here is caved in right down here because of, it was ran over something underneath. And again, it's kind of hard to see it, but that is crunched up pretty good, and there's actually a rip in the aluminum back there. So I'm gonna put a jack. I'm gonna try putting a jack in there. We'll put a board up on top, and we're just gonna try and get enough pressure to force that down flat or close to flat, so then it'll push the metal that's outside back out, and then we'll hammer dolly whatever we can that's left. So let's take a peek. Let me show you outside or underneath what it looks like. There's a little bit better view of it. Kind of hard to see with the angle of the camera, but I think if we force down right here, we might be able to push out right where the mud dauber nest is. And if you look down the line, you can see that we come in here and then about the step is where it comes out normal. And this is pretty thick stuff right here. But it is aluminum, so we should be able to kind of make it do what we want it to do. Yep, let's go in and see if we can't put that where it needs to be. Yeah, I've been working on it for a little while, and probably about an hour. It's pretty good. There's a little bit still right there, but it's right in the line where I can't get to it, but it feels pretty smooth. Inside here, it looks better. I've still got just a little bit of height right there, and then obviously the split. I need to work on with a thinner screwdriver or something to get in there where I can actually hammer. It's really hard to get in there. The jack only did so much where you had to, you know, get a hammer and beat on it. But I've been going under and kind of popping it right here and giving it some relief. That seems to be working pretty well. It's much, much better. And the license plate area up here, the taillight license plate, was all caved in. And right here where you see that line is right where that piece is riveted to. So I can't get a hammer. I need to get a hammer right there, and I can't. And I don't want to drill those rivets out and get all of that out of there. So I think we're going to live with it for right now. The light is going to be here, and then the license plate down here. So I'm not too worried about that area. It's just that corner right there. And that's about the best I can do. My camera's not wanting to focus on it. So I think we're going to live with it. It's not bad. Much better than it was. I would like to get right there popped out just a little bit more. But I think I'm going to stop working on that for a bit. There is a dent up on the front icebox door that I might work on while I've kind of got everything out here. Right there. See it? It's not a bad one, but I think if I can bang that out, I think we'll be in pretty good shape to start hitting this thing again on polish. Yeah, still seeing it a little bit, but not near like it was. I'm just using, sliding this on the front and then from the backside. So if I do leave a hammer mark, it's on the backside. It's pretty good. There was one right here too, right there. Again, you can still see it, but you gotta kind of know it's there. There's one down there I'm seeing, might be able to get. But you know, it's 1946, this trailer's 75 years old. So you expect a few dings along the way, right? Doesn't look too bad though. So just starting on this front here, you can see around all the snaps and kind of just around the areas. It's just kind of got that white film. I worked right here just now, just around that snap right there. Not perfect, but I'll hit it one more time around that one. And I think that one's pretty good. You can see the difference between that one and that one. So I'm gonna work on this front panel tonight because I'm kind of a eat the frog. I've mentioned that in the last couple of videos. It seems to be my phrase lately. But I kind of want to do the hard thing first, the hardest part of it first. And the front going around all these little turns. We can't break any of these because they are a specialty little doodad. So we don't want to break any of those if we can help it. So I'm going to try to be real careful and not hit those. I'll try to do this front. Obviously, I want to stay out of the tag too. I don't know that I can get that off. I haven't tried. But I want to not hit that too much if I can help it. I don't want to wear it out. And I just noticed another dent as I was starting on this front section here. And it's probably in an area I can't get. Yeah, I can't get a picture of it. It's right there. Can't really see it, but some of these dents are really hard to get to because they're in the little cubbies and right against the wall where you can't hit them real well. So that's why those dents are still there, because nobody else could hit them either. So we may try to work on that one. Let's polish it up and see what it looks like before we get too crazy though. So I'll bring you back. It's kind of just boring, monotonous work. I am using the Zephyr wheels on it. And I went ahead and ordered another one of this first stage. And then we're using the little wax blocks to put our paste on. So it's coming along, it's just slow going. I'll keep at it and bring you back, hopefully, when this front panel section is done. Storm finally rolled in, so I think maybe you can see the difference now without the glaring sun. Before you couldn't see it. I'm glad the storm rolled in. The temperature, it said it felt like 105 today with the heat index, so I'm glad that it has cooled off a wee bit. But I think you could see in the reflection of the tongue the difference. The door, the center of the door, I have not done. And the lower strip right down here. You can just see in my reflection my legs versus upper. The reflection's significantly different. You step up there and you can really see it with the tongue of the trailer. So I need to hit around the snaps again, it looks like, one more time. And then maybe just kind of overall polish. Hardly ever see that on our road. But just kind of overall hit it again with a buff, and then it looks like maybe right here in this lower corner. I'm going to try and get that dent later. I think I can get to it. It's kind of right where the little cubbies are, so it's going to be kind of hard to get to. If we can't get it, it's not a huge deal. But I'm pretty happy with how that's turning out. And this is the first cut, so there are two more wheels and two more buff these little buff bars, the wax bars that go on there. And a little trick I found going around these little guys, that was kind of tricky. I just took this and kind of caked it around there. Seemed to work a lot better. I did okay getting around those. That's really tight. And the thing is, if I break one, I'm screwed because they're like a rivet. I don't know how to, they're like riveted from the back side. So don't want to break one of those suckers. So I guess I'll spend the rest of the time here, if we don't get too wet from the storm, and just kind of finish out this front section. I'm really happy with how that's come along, though. Big difference from where we started. So two more cuts on that. I think we'll be in good shape. She's coming in. We need the rain, though. Seems like it's always... always storming when I'm filming. Storming or somebody's mowing the lawn. All right, let's finish this one out. Well, here is the first cut on the front. It isn't perfect. And again, it's just the first cut. You can see the reflection of the tongue is pretty good there. I've got some wax I can see, that residue that needs to come off. The bulk of my time, I got about 3 hours in this front section. The bulk of my time was on these little dudes, going around those without breaking them off. I found if I turned the wheel down as I hit this lip and hit those, if I turned it down to about 2,500, 3,000, it did a lot better. Got maybe a little bit of work right here to do, it looks like. Not bad overall, though. Not bad. Much improvement from when I started. So, can you see my reflection? Kind of. It's getting there. The Higgins popped pretty good. I think it's funny that the ones that had the icebox in, the Higgins name isn't up a little bit. So they just ran the icebox door right over it. Cut it out. Yeah, we're getting there. I think next I'm going to jump on. The sides are going to be easy, so I'm not going to worry about those. But the one pieces on the back, the one corner, this corner is kind of dull, and then the back has all these hinges and stuff. We bought a replacement weather strip or whatever, door strip, for the tailgate. The one that's on the main body of the trailer, I'm gonna try and leave. Let me turn some lights on and see if that helps us. I don't know if that's better or worse, but you can definitely see this side is better than the back, so I'm gonna jump to the back and work on it. It's got that kind of that waxy stuff like the front did. We know it's possible to get it off of there. And then this side here is in pretty decent shape. It needs to be hit again. one more time. And then we'll jump to the next cut wheel. Well, I don't think the back is yet as good as the front, but it's much better. You can see the reflection of the beetle in it now. But it's getting there. I think I need to hit it one more time with that stage before we jump to the next one. I think the front is ready for the next stage, but this one I think needs to be hit again. Looks much, much better though. And my part I banged out doesn't look half bad. Up here, I can see in camera, I need to hit this again. But overall, not too bad. If that's as good as it gets, I can live with that. Need to kind of hit some of these areas. Of course, this will be covered with your taillight license plate, so I'm not gonna focus too much on that because you're not gonna see it. Tried to work really hard to get the corners with a good shine. I think we did pretty decent on that. So we're getting there. I do want to turn the camera around though, so you can see my ugly mug to see what you look like after you've polished aluminum. I look like a chimney sweep. You gotta see my arms. How nice is that? And I stepped out in the rain, so I got a few raindrops on me. But we're getting there. So I'll keep at it and I'll bring you back when we're probably on that next stage or onto the lids. It's getting there. Takes some time and takes some effort, and it costs a little bit of money to get that done, but I think we'll be happy with it. Yeah, I started on the lids, and I will say that once the block that you're using kind of starts to get that blackened look to it, it's not getting the full wax on it. So just want to mention, trial and error. I'm learning as I go. First time I've ever done one of these. I took, this is just a little, like, I guess it's brass wire wheel, and I just put it in the drill and then run it along there. You could tell a huge difference in running that through and then putting it on your buff wheel versus not. So I will say, if you can keep the block, the wax block, a little cleaner, then it does do a better job. So for example, this is without cleaning the block. You can see that little section right there. And then just past it is after I cleaned the block. You can get a lot further too, because you get more wax on your wheel. So just thought I would share that. We do have a rasp, or whatever this thing is called, that you can clean the wheels off. So that helps too, but cleaning the wax block seems to be pretty effective. I mean, you can clearly see the line right there where I cleaned it. So I just thought I'd mention that real quick since I'm on the lid. These are pretty flat, pretty easy to get to, but it's a lot of surface area I've got to cover. The ends cleaned up really nice, the little Higgins ends. I guess they are aluminum, I don't know. That one probably needs hit again, but it was cleaned up kind of nice. You can now read them at least. So I'm gonna continue on with this. This is probably gonna take me most of the day to do these two lids. And then the whole trailer will have been hit once. Oh, I got, need to hit that, don't I? Missed a spot. It's coming along, but you know, this is not a quick process at all. It's just something that takes time. The door I need to hit again, this door. It was getting kind of dark last night and I just really couldn't tell what I was doing, so I wanted to wait. I don't want to tear something up, you know. So I'll hit it again. These lines here probably are not going to come out. It's where that lid latch was swinging back and forth. So it's actually scraped the the metal. My corner doesn't look terrible. It still needs some work, but you know, I could spend a week on that. So I want to make sure we get it polished before we go to the rally. Then I'll come back and start working on that again. It's good enough where the polish is actually hitting it now, unlike before. So let me carry on with this process. I keep jumping around, so it looks like I don't have a method to the madness, but I don't want the aluminum to overheat. And it's pretty hot out again today, and it just gets hot. I don't want it to warp. I know we'd have to get pretty hot to do that, but it doesn't take long for that to heat up. So I do work a spot, jump to a different spot, and then I'll jump down there and come back here. Just kind of try to keep hopping back and forth. I've hit this edge right here all the way down. Try and do the hard stuff first, you know, hit the corners, hit the edges, and then you can just cruise. I did notice down here, though, where the hinge is, there's a spot, I don't know if you can see it, right there that's through. When they put dissimilar metals, so I'll have to inspect where those hinges mount, and then we may have to fill that right there. Yeah, it's pretty weak right there. So we're probably gonna have to do a little bit of a aluminum repair there. The rest of them feel pretty good. Yeah, I think the rest of them are usable. But when they put dissimilar metal, so they put a steel hinge on with the aluminum, and it caused, you know, it doesn't rust, but it corrodes it away. Same thing happened with the Land Rover on the door hinge. I'll go show you that. So the entire truck, this entire Rover, is aluminum. I sanded it down 15 years ago, 10 years ago, something like that. I don't remember when I did that, but it has been bare metal since then in these areas here. And I wish I'd have known about goof off then, because we wouldn't have kind of this stuff going on, but I didn't. So everything on it is aluminum. The frame is galvanized steel, but the bulkhead is not. And you can see where this starts to rust, and it causes the corrosion right here on the doors. So the doors are aluminum, but because they've been close to that steel and touching that steel, they also start to corrode in a different way. They don't rust, they just kind of like rot out. It's kind of bizarre. So this truck's kind of done the same thing that happened onto that trailer. Just thought I'd point that out. Well, while the little buffer slash grinder is kind of cooling off, I went ahead and took the wheels off. I thought I was going to be able to throw our other trailer tires on there, but they're just too wide to get in there. And the new ones we bought are going to be kind of tight, but threw the spare on one side, and then just threw a jack stand or two underneath on this side. But I bought this little handheld sandblaster. This was an Amazon deal of the day. And I thought, yeah, that's not going to work. It was $12. Okay, $12.99, something like that. And I thought, it even says on it, you know, Amazon Basics. I'm like, that thing is going to be a big piece of junk. Okay, in about 2 minutes, this wheel sandblasted with two tanks on the hopper. And I haven't touched this wheel yet. The only complaint I have is when you first tip it, it pours out a little bit of sand, so you lose a little bit before you pull the trigger. But I will say, I'm pretty impressed. It's a comfortable grip. It's not too heavy. It's easy to get into tight spaces. I like it. That was a good $13 spent. Okay, I gotta admit, I'm pretty impressed with that little tool. That will come in very handy. So I've just got playing cards. I usually turn them the other way, but I'm not playing with the full deck. Yeah. So I wanted to go ahead and mock them both up at the same time. These are clear playing cards. Kind of a weird concept. Can't find my Elvis cards, so this is what we've got to work with. So I'm gonna spray paint these a forest green. Hopefully it turns out okay. This probably isn't gonna show up real well on camera, but one of these colors is not like the other. That's supposed to be hunter green. This is dark hunter green. This looks like John Deere green to me. This looks like hunter green. So I had a can that barely sprays. Got one done. Let's repaint that guy. There's our canvas material. It's pretty close. Probably as close as we're gonna get. Not too bad. And what do we think for hubcap? Tan or light green? And yes, I went ahead and painted them before I had the new tires on, because I can get a good coat of paint on them, and then if I need to do any touch-up, I can just pull the same trick I pulled with these. But they did a pretty good job the last time, and I painted them beforehand, so I think we'll be okay. Maybe not. We might be doing touch-up, but at least they have a decent coat of paint on them now. Just give you a reference point too, that's about 20 minutes of work right there. So that's hours of work. Imagine what an Airstream is. So I'll probably have 2 hours in this door and 2 hours in the other one. Hopefully we can get it done in 4 hours. I'm not gonna get much done if I keep yapping though. Let's get at it. Yeah, I'm pretty well done with the trailer. The lids are pretty pitted up. They've got some pitting going on and just some kind of funky stuff going on. So I've cut one cut on this one, and then I've just gone back over it with the wheel without any wax on it, and that seemed to have helped. There's a few areas that still need just a little bit more work, but I think the first cut on that, I mean, you can see a reflection in it. You can see, you know, the bikes hanging from the ceiling and that kind of thing. But it's just not popping quite like the front of the trailer did. And I'm okay with it, because when the camper is set up, these are turned down. You don't even see them. So I'm going to spend some time. We're going to go over this one with the white buff wheel, because I've been over the whole thing. You can see here, too. You can see where I cut. I went back in and tried cutting with the white wheel just to see what happened. Well, it's not that good. So I'm going to go back over that section right there. With the yellow, that's the first step, and then maybe hit this section right here. You can see a little milkiness there, and then I think we'll hit it with the white and call it good. I mean, at some point you just kind of have to quit. And then I'm going to wait to hit these on the edges until it's on the trailer, because it'll be at a good height. It'll be at waist height, a little bit taller than waist height, so I'll be able to make that a little bit shinier when it's sitting up there, because I'd be able to get good pressure on it. The tires are on. It is a little bit taller than it was. Let me get you out of here. We've got it sitting on a 2-inch board. It angled down just a little bit before, but those tires are probably about, I don't know, at least an inch different than the old ones. But they look good. I like them, and for the cost of those and the similarity to what was on it, I think they're the only choice we kind of had at this point. If we find something different, I can always change them out. But yeah, I think I'm done with the trailer. Just got to paint the tongue. I don't want to paint anything. The tongue and leaf springs, I'm just going to paint black. I don't want to paint anything until I'm done kind of sanding. Not sanding, but buffing, because it just makes such a mess. The kickstand I moved, it was where the big hole was, so I moved it forward and up, hoping it would clear that back there, but it still hits, so I'm still gonna have to shave off a little bit from it. I don't know why that is. You think they would have made that, it's notched out down there, so you think when it swings up in transit it should clear that front section. So I don't know what the story is on that. We're gonna just shave off. It needs about an eighth of an inch shaved off to clear those bolts. I thought about shearing the head of the bolt, shaving it a little bit, but then if I ever need to take that off, it's going to be hard to get those out without drilling them out. So I think I'll just shave the harder section, which is this guy. So I got to get a longer bolt for up here, put a hardened bolt through it, and a lock washer so that we can
be good to go on that. Wiring, gotta do that. And put the taillights on. I think this is pretty well ready to go. So I just wanted to mention on something like this, I have found that actually lowering the speed, I mentioned earlier that I had dropped the speed down to 3,500, I think, or something like that, thinking that this was a 6,000 buff wheel, but it's not. This only goes to 3,500, so setting the little clicker to 3 is what I meant by that. But I have found if you kind of sit it and just kind of let the weight, you know, a grinder or a buff wheel or anything like that has a way that it wants to walk. So if you kind of work with that and make use that to your advantage, makes it a lot easier instead of working against it. So yeah, found if you put that on about 4, between 3 and 4, and just kind of walk it slowly back and forth and start from the bottom and work your way up, I found that that works a little bit better. So I'm going to continue on, stopping on the trailer. I think we're good on that. This side is definitely better. I might hit the other side with the purple wheel. It's not quite, doesn't quite have that pop to it. It's really close. There's just some area right in here that's a little bit dull. And I don't know if it's the metal or the polish. So we may try hitting that again. But for right now, we're just going to try to focus on getting the lids done and getting them back on. And these are not going to get a full cut because I just don't have the time. There's so much stuff I got to get done. I don't have the time. So we're going to cut them once, buff them with the white once, which is the next wheel. And I'm going to call it good. That's all I got. Got the icebox kind of just wire wheeled. It's a different aluminum than the camper's made out of, so it doesn't polish up quite as nice. And then just sprayed that flex seal inside. There were some pits and things inside the cooler, so it's all fresh and clean. The seals have been soaked in hot soapy water. They are clean. They are stained a little bit, but they are clean. So this thing is pretty much ready to rock and roll. What do you think? Looks pretty shiny. Tail lights are in. Just gotta put the bed lids on. Kind of dusty right now, but that's pretty much all we have left on this, and the seal that goes around the door. And we just got some carpet we're gonna stick in there. That is original floor paint, so I'm gonna leave it. It's kind of cool. Put a grippy on the step. Yeah, let me go pop those lights on, show you what those look like. Look pretty good. The one that has the license plate light on it, the lens is a little darker. So I put an LED bulb in it, trying to make them kind of equal. Let me go turn the carport lights off and we'll see what it looks like. Yeah, there we are, all lit up. The flash is on the camera. There's a reflective stripe right here. Shows up really nice. Yeah, they look pretty good. I like it. Got that vintage vibe going on. Yeah, this is good.
Well, I think we're about ready to hit it. Got everything all hooked up. I've got a 6-inch raise on this hitch and it's still not enough. Thing just sits up high. Pretty good look though. I like it. It's about 100 degrees a day, so we're going with the doors off. Yeah, it's good. I like it.